गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स, टुडेज टॉपिक इज नेफ्रोटिक सिंड्रोम। नेफ्रोटिक सिंड्रोम इट इज अ टाइप ऑफ रीनल फेलियर। इट इज कैरेक्टराइज्ड बाय मैसिव प्रोटीनुरिया। Because of massive proteinuria, there is generalized edema. So the definition is includes these two criteria in nephrotic syndrome. Let us now see the causes of nephrotic syndrome. Normally, nephrotic syndrome is a disease of the children, but in adults, because of any other type of disease, secondary to that disease, nephrotic syndrome can occur. Also, some of the kidney diseases which causes damage to the glomerulus can also initiate nephrotic syndrome. Why it is called as a syndrome? Because it is a collection of symptoms causing the disease. So now we will see the causes of nephrotic syndrome. Causes. Any type of kidney disease like membranous nephropathy, or glomerulosclerosis, because of any other disease, the kidneys will be damaged, resulting in nephrotic syndrome. Secondary causes include diabetes, lupus, that is SLE, any type of autoimmune disease like sarcoidosis, multiple myeloma, cancers. In all these cases, nephrotic syndrome can occur secondary to that particular type of disease. Clear? Now next we will see the pathophysiology. That means the changes which occur in the body as well as in the kidney due to nephrotic syndrome. Pathophysiology goes like this. Damaged glomerulus or glomerular capillaries. Which is causing proteinuria, as I have said in the definition. So loss of plasma proteins will cause two things. One, it will stimulate liver to produce lipids or lipoprotein, which will cause increase in the level of lipids in the blood. So, if nephrotic syndrome, there will be hyperlipidemia. That means increased level of lipids or lipoproteins in the blood. Another change, which is a major change that you will see, loss of plasma protein causes decreased osmotic pressure. Of intravascular volume. The next thing I will write here, I will rub this the whole thing. So decrease osmotic pressure of intravascular volume, that means in the blood, when the osmotic pressure falls, then it will cause fluid to move out from the intravascular space. To the interstitial space, causing edema. This edema is generalized. That you must remember. Generalized means the whole body is affected. Edema will be seen under the eyes, around the sacrum, in the abdomen, which is called as ascites, ankles, in the hands. Everywhere there will be edema. Now, when the fluid moves out from the intravascular space, so the intravascular volume, that means intravascular, IV is, here IV is not intravenous, intravascular volume is reduced. So reduced intravascular volume stimulates renin-angiotensin pathway. In short, when the body fluid is less, then also the renin-angiotensin pathway is activated. When renin-angiotensin pathway is activated, then it causes retention of sodium and water. Sodium and water retention. Again, this sodium and water retention will cause edema. So, in nephrotic syndrome, primarily patient will have massive proteinuria and generalized edema. This is all about the pathophysiology of nephrotic syndrome. Now let us see the clinical manifestations of nephrotic syndrome. The clinical manifestation, as I have already discussed, one is massive proteinuria. How much protein is lost from the body? Around more than 3.5 gram per day. More than 3.5 gram per day protein is lost from the urine. And therefore the serum albumin or the protein level in the blood is reduced. It is less than 2.5 protein is less than 2.5 gram per deciliter. There will be diffuse edema. I have already said proteinuria. Next, edema, then decreased amount of albumin in the blood, so it is called as hypoalbuminemia. Then there will be increased level of lipids in the blood, which is called as hyperlipidemia. Other clinical features will be the patient will be very much tired. There will be generalized malaise. Then there will be headache experienced by the patient. One should remember that in nephrotic syndrome there is no oliguria, there is no hypertension, which was seen in glomerulonephritis. In that there was hematuria, there was oliguria, and the patient also had hypertension. Here there is no hypertension. Hypertension can occur if sodium and water retention occurs in a massive extent, then hypertension can occur. Otherwise, there is no oliguria in these patients, no hematuria in the patients. So this is all about the clinical manifestations of nephrotic syndrome. Let us now see the diagnostic test. Diagnostic tests are, first, urine analysis. Urine analysis, a detailed analysis will show that the proteins are very high in the urine, which I have already said that it is around 3.5 grams per day. Then if you are doing dipstick analysis, dipstick method, in that the change, the indication will be around 3 plus to 4 plus. That means massive proteinuria is seen in the urine. Then confirmatory diagnosis will be needle biopsy of urine. Other tests are blood tests. In that you can do the serum albumin level as well as serum cholesterol level. So the cholesterol level will rise because of increased amount of lipoprotein. Now let us see the complications related to the disease. The complications are it is a type of renal failure. The prognosis of the disease is quite good, but if it is not cured properly, then one can end up into acute renal failure or acute kidney injury, you can say. Can progress into CRF, chronic renal failure, or ESRD, end stage renal disease. This is the first complication. After that, thromboembolism. Thromboembolism is due to increased lipoprotein and also increased level of fibrinogen in the blood. Then next is accelerated atherosclerosis because of lipoprotein, increased lipidemia, hyperlipidemia. And in these patients, they are prone for infection because the plasma proteins are lost, which helps in immune response. So these patients are prone for many type of infections. Now you will see the medical management. The medical management includes steroids. In glomerular nephritis also, steroid was given. Here, steroids are given, immunosuppressants are given. Immunosuppressants and steroids will reduce the proteinuria. After that, patients are given ACE inhibitor so that the renin-angiotensin pathway is inhibited and less amount of sodium and water retention is there. After that, statins. These drugs are given to reduce the lipids in the blood for a short duration. After that, low sodium diet is given for the patient because of generalized edema, and low fat diet is also prescribed. So this is all about nephrotic syndrome. Hope you have understood. If you have any doubt, you can consult to me. Thank you, students.